Sakshi from YouTube channel Study with Sakshi Gaur. So in this video we are going to know about tissues class 9 chapter 2 of biology grade 9. So let us start with the chapter before any delay and before any of the delay. So let us start the chapter. So what we have studied till now, we have studied about introduction for this chapter, introduction. So what we have done in the part one, we have done introduction, then we have done the meristematic tissue complete. In this video, in second video, we have done about simple permanent tissue parenchyma. Okay, simple permanent tissue parenchyma plus revision of first chapter or first part. And now we are going in the third video, we are going to do one shot for plant tissues. So can we start with today's video? So this is a one shot, so we are going to revise all of that. So we are going to revise plant tissue all. So let's start with the preparation one. And that you can see now properly. Can it change? Okay. So now let us start with today's. Okay. So let's start with today's video. So first, see production. All the plants, animals, all the organisms are made up of cells. Okay. So all the organisms are made up of cells. In unicellular organism, only one cell do all the functions that are needed by that amoeba or any unicellular organism. Okay. So in multicellular organism, there we can see a division of labor. We can see, and this single cell, in unicellular organism, one single cell performs all the functions for the amoeba. Okay. So we can see that the division of labor can be seen in the multicellular organism. So what is a tissue? Tissue is a group of cells that are working together to perform a specific function is known as tissues. Okay, the term tissue. The term tissue was coined by Bichat in 1792. If you want to study about tissues in a higher grade, you have to do what? You have to do histology. Histology means study of tissues. So the term histology was coined by Meyer in 1819. Okay, everyone. So I think this is clear. So importance of tissue. Tissue brought a division of labor in multicellular organism. Tissues combine to form organs, organs into organ systems, and organ system to organism. Let me explain this thing with you all. So what is this? A cell combined to form an tissue. Tissue into organ. Organ into organ system, and organ system into organism. So these are combining to form a simple structure. A workload of individual cells are decreased. Ek cell ke workload jo hai, it is decreased because of many tissues. There are two types of tissue, plant tissue and animal tissues. So types of plant tissue. In this video we are going to do plant tissues. Types of plant tissue. Plant tissues are of two types, permanent and meristematic. Meristematic are of three types. Okay? meristematics are of three types, apical, intercalary and lateral. And permanent tissues are of two types, simple permanent and complex permanent. Simple permanent are of three types, parenchyma, collenchyma, sclerenchyma. And complex permanent are of two types, xylem and phloem. So I hope that this clear. This chart is clear. So now we are going to cover meristematic tissue. Meristematic tissue is a thin walled, compactly arranged part of a tissue or part of cells that function is to just divide and form new cells and do growth for the plant. Meristematic tissue is also known as meristem, and these meristematic tissue cells are known as meristematic cells. So where the meristematic cells are present, that region will be called as growth region, because meristematic cells are only found where the growth is needed, growth of that plant or growth of that region is needed. There is characteristics of meristematic cells. So let me apni video ko chhota kar lete hain. Okay. Shape and size. So meristematic cells are generally small in size and the shape is spherical or polygonal. Cell wall is thin and elastic. Intercellular spaces are generally absent. They are compactly packed. They are tightly packed. Intercellular spaces, they are compactly packed. Contains nucleus is large, dense cytoplasm, and vacuoles are small, as like plants or animal cells. Activity as respiration is rapid. There is a high synthetic of activity because they have to do a division and they need energy to do that all. Food supply is high, but food is not stored because of their work. Meristematic cells grow and divide rapidly. So function of meristematic cells. So meristematic cells are known as parent tissue. Parent cells for all, because they are only that can divide growth. Meristematic tissue take part in the formation of new cells, organs. These meristematic cells divide and form an organ into organ system at this time. Injury, where there is an injury, they heal it up by forming new cells and logging. Okay. Location of meristems. I told you that meristematic cells are of three types: apical, intercalary, and lateral. Apical are at the top of the plant, like this is my plant. So this is my plant, and they are present on the top of plant because the reason of top is like the reason of a growth. Reason of growth, and they are also present at the root of tip of root because root also grows. Root also grows and it is like a tip. So apical meristem are present on stem, on the stem of the top and root. Intercalary internodes or nodes ke paas hoti hai, because that grows that internodes and nodes. Lateral chodai. Lateral increases chodai. Lateral chodai badhata hai plant. So I hope it is clear. Okay, so in this video we are going to know, presentation we are going to know about simple permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Let us start that. Permanent tissues are those tissues which have lost the ability to divide and they have their specific space, shape and function. They are derived from meristematic cells. As I told you, meristematic cells are the parent cells for all. The process of taking of a definite shape, size, structure and function is known as differentiation. The process of taking a specific shape, function, size, structure is known as differentiation. Please give it स्टार्स यू हैव टू राइट इट। आप इसको अपनी नोट्स वाली नोटबुक पर 2-3 जितने में 4 देने दो, इसको लर्न करो। परमानेंट टिश्यू में भी सिंपल कॉम्प्लेक्स स्पेशल देयर सेल्स में भी लिविंग नॉन लिविंग डेड थिन वॉल्ड और थिक वॉल्ड, ठीक है। थिकनिंग में भी रेगुलर और इरेगुलर। करेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ परमानेंट टिश्यूज, सो लेट मी टेल यू द करेक्टरिस्टिक्स। हाँ, शेप एंड साइज। सो द सेल्स हैव अटेन्ड देयर शेप एंड साइज एंड दे डू नॉट इंक्रीज देयर शेप आफ्टरवर्ड्स। स्पेसिफिक फंक्शंस, द सेल्स हैव अटेन्ड देयर स्पेसिफिक फंक्शंस एंड दे ओनली डू देयर फंक्शंस दैट दे हैव टू परफॉर्म। ओके, सो नाउ वॉल। से देयर वॉल कैन बी थिन और थिक, it is not compulsory that it had a thick wall or thin wall, it can be thin or thick। division, permanent cells are permanent cells normally do not divide, so permanent cells do not divide life, so permanent cells may be living or dead। मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स एंड परमानेंट सेल्स, सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन मेरिस्टमैटिक एंड परमानेंट। सो मेरिस्टमैटिक सेल्स आर जनरली स्मॉल इन साइज, आइसोट्रॉमिक एंड अनडिफरेंशिएटेड, व्हेरएज दीज आर डिफरेंशिएटेड एंड दे आर ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स। इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस आर एब्सेंट एंड इन दिस केस इंटरसेलुलर स्पेसेस आर प्रेजेंट। देयर वैक्यूल्स आर नियरली एब्सेंट बिकॉज देयर वर्क इज टू लाइक divide only, in this large vacuoles are present। एक मिनट। Nucleus is large and prominent, generally nucleus का यहाँ पर कोई ज्यादा काम वगैरह होता नहीं। Cell wall is thin, whereas this in this case cell wall can be thin or thick। Divisions, they do not undergo division, permanent cells do not undergo division, whereas meristematic cells undergo division। Metabolism, rate of metabolism is high in the case of meristematic cells, whereas permanent cells, permanent tissues have low metabolic rate। Life, the cells can be living, but in the case of permanent, the cells can not be living or non-living। Okay, so function, it take part in growth, their function is to provide protection, support, conduction। Oh my god, camera hila kya? I think it's so। ठीक है, मैं fix कर देती हूँ। Conduction, photosynthesis, storage। So let me fix the camera। Camera, okay। So let me change also the light color। I think this is cool। Okay, so this is cool। So now simple permanent tissues, simple permanent tissues are of 3 types, these types are parenchyma, sclerenchyma and collenchyma। Parenchyma ke bare mein baat kar lete hain, parenchyma they are thin walled and ye isodermic hote hain, jiski cell size equal hoti hai, and these are packaging tissues। It is abundant tissue, they are oval spherical polyrhombal in outline। The central vacuole is large, there is a central vacuole of cytoplasm containing the nucleus। Location, occurs in all parts of the plant like stem, fruit, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc। Functions, their function is to store food, give the support to plant, gases exchange, waste product। स्लो ट्रांसपोर्ट, क्लोरेनकाइमा, एरेनकाइमा एंड एपिडर्मिस। क्लोरेनकाइमा जिसके पास क्लोरोफिल होता है, एरेनकाइमा जोन सा पैरेनकाइमा हाइड्रो एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स में प्रेजेंट होता है, जिसके पास कैविटीज होती हैं जो प्लांट्स को फ्लोट करने में हेल्प करती हैं। सो अब हम बात कर लेते हैं स्क्लेरेनकाइमा की। चला या नहीं, टेन वर्क ही नहीं कर रहा, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग देन? चलो भाई चलो, नहीं चल रहा, कोई बात नहीं, हम पॉइंटर के साथ कर लेंगे, पॉइंटर है ना हमारे पास, ठीक है। द सिंपल परमानेंट इश्यूज आर डेड एंड वीडियोज ना आया करो, मैंने शोर मंदिर थोड़े सामने मुन भी नहीं आ